art's awesome because it's our expression.
Or I have a wonderful electronic effect.
Photographers are problem solvers. That's what we do. It's important to understand that you have real problems now. And with CGI coming into play and eating industries, you need to start solving that problem for you as a creative and know how you're going to handle those. So what we're doing in this tutorial is essentially breaking down that 20% of knowledge that you need to know. The learning curve in the software we're using here is insanely fast. I feel like this is just like picking up Photoshop for the first time. You just attack it with an open mind, and at the end of the day, you're going to be able to start creating effortlessly
in our creation toolbar here in the top command panel. Now you'll see this little blue icon that is the bend deformer. Now if we hold that down, this entire list is a list of deformers that we can use to manipulate our 3D objects.
By the end of this tutorial, it's going to be one of those things for you where you're already starting to get comfortable using it without even realizing that you're doing so.
And then we can actually add another light that's going to be targeting just the background, or going to be hitting just the background object here.
But we also start to go over different projects together and my style of work so that I can show you how I get my work done quickly to get a great end result.
So what we can do is go ahead and click ambient light. And now if we go ahead into our octane light that's up top, let's go ahead and move this back just a little ways in the viewport.
What we've included in this tutorial is amazing. So we've got really high level product, which is the mouse. Jeff DeVries, awesome industry 3D modeler, put this together for us. It's at industry standard quality. We're also building our first set together that we had modeled, and now it's going to be yours. We're going to go through and put materials on this 3D set. I'm going to show you how to light it, how to render it, how to move those lights around your environment to maybe match your subjects that you shoot in studio, and then do post. Post-production is always a part of 3D, just like it is in photography, and you'll be able to use all of those skills that you already have in your toolbox to make your renders even better. One of the biggest things that we can do is adapt. And what I would tell you to do at this point is start to learn CGI. Not necessarily every step and portion that goes into it, but get to know the fundamentals. Know what that process looks like. Start learning how to implement that into your work so that as you start to look for other people that can do this with you and you build a team, you know what to look for.